Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
This is continuation of previous video of strap foundation design. In this video, I will design strap foundation design using FEM method, strap foundation design using strip method, strap beam design, and strap beam detailing in SAFE version 12. Let's first check movement and shear diagrams of beam and foundation. Go to display, click on show beam forces stresses. Select load combination to UDCON U2, that is 1.2 dead load plus 1.6 live load. Choose major movement in component. Check show values at controlling station in diagram. Click on apply. This is movement diagram on beam with maximum top face movement of 768.3 kF. Go to display. Click on show beam forces stresses. Choose major shear in component. This is shear diagram on beam with maximum shear of 54.2 kips. Go to display. Click on show slab forces stresses. Select load combination to UDCON U2, that is 1.2 dead load plus 1.6 live load. Choose M11 movement in component, click on apply. This is M11 movement contours on foundation. As you move cursor on these, it will show you movement values. Go to display, click on show slab forces stresses. This time choose M22 movement in component. Click on apply. This is M22 movement contours on foundation. As you move cursor on these, it will show you movement values. First, I am designing slab using finite element method. Go to display. Click on show slab design. Check impose minimum reinforcing. Choose direction 1 bottom rebar, which is X direction reinforcement. Choose option typical uniform reinforcing specified below. Select number 5 at 5 in center to center bottom reinforcement. Click on apply. This is contour showing on foundation where extra reinforcement required after placing number 5 at 5 in center to center. Increasing number of bars so that no extra reinforcement required. See, using number 6 at 5 in center to center, no extra reinforcement required in eccentric foundation. Increasing number of bar. See, after using number 9 at 5 in center to center reinforcement, no extra reinforcement required in concentric foundation. Now choose direction 2 bottom rebar, which is Y direction reinforcement. Change bottom rebar to number 5 at 5 in center to center. Click on apply. There is extra reinforcement required. So increasing number of bar. See, using number 8 at 5 in center to center reinforcement, no extra reinforcement required in concentric foundation. Increasing number of bar. See, after using number 9 at 5 in center to center reinforcement, no extra reinforcement required in eccentric foundation. Now choose direction 1 top rebar. Uncheck impose minimum reinforcement as this is isolated footing, so we just use design reinforcement required in top face, not minimum reinforcement criteria. Likewise for top reinforcement, after using number 6 at 5 in center to center reinforcement, no extra reinforcement required in eccentric foundation. As I use number 3 at 5 in center to center top reinforcement, no extra reinforcement required in concentric foundation. Choose direction 2 top rebar, select number 3 at 5 in center to center top reinforcement, click on apply. See, no extra reinforcement required after number 3 at 5 in center to center. This is result of foundations using FEM method. Designing of strap beam flexural and shear reinforcement. Go to display. Click on show beam design. Select longitudinal rebar in design type. Check show values at controlling station in diagram in display option. Check reinforcing extent and click on apply. This is showing beam top and bottom flexural reinforcement. Top reinforcement is 4.57 inches square. Using number 8 bar having area of 0.785 inches square, divide 4.57 with 0.785 equals to 5.8. That is, top reinforcement is 6 number 8 bars. Bottom reinforcement is 1.46 inches square. Using number 5 bar having area of 0.306 inches square, divide 1.46 with 0.306 equals to 4.7. So I am using 6 number 5 bottom reinforcement. Go to display, click on show beam design. This time select transverse rebar. Click on apply. See, no shear reinforcement need as per design, but should provide minimum reinforcement as per ACI code. Designing of strip foundation using strip method. So first we have to draw design strip. In order to do that, go to draw, click on draw dimension lines. Go to draw, click on draw design strip. Strip layer A is X direction strip and strip layer B is Y direction strip. For concentric isolated foundation, column strip left and right width in both direction is L by 2, that is 10.75 divided with 2 equals to 5.375 feet. For eccentric foundation, strip layer A, which is X direction strip, left and right width of strip is L by 2, that is 18 divided with 2 equals to 9 feet. Strip layer B, which is Y direction strip, has left width equals to half column dimension as footing edge is matching with column edge when draw strip from center line of column. Strip layer B has right width remaining is 5 feet. Go to display, show slab design. Select strip method for design. Check impose minimum reinforcing. Check layer A and also check bottom rebar only. Check show values at controlling station in diagram. Select show number of bar of size to number 5. Uncheck show reinforcing envelope diagram and check show reinforcing extent. Click on apply. This is showing bottom X reinforcement. Concentric foundation required 28 number 5 bars. Spacing is 10.75 into 12 divided with 28 equals to 4.6 inch. So providing number 5 at 4.5 inch center to center. Eccentric foundation required 38 number 5 bars. Spacing is 18 multiplied 12 divided with 38 equals to 5.68 inch. Uncheck layer A and check layer B. Click on apply. This is showing bottom Y reinforcement. Concentric foundation required 28 number 5 bars. Spacing is 10.75 multiplied 12 divided with 28 equals to 4.6 inch. So providing number 5 at 4.5 inch center to center. For eccentric foundation, 36 number 5 bars cannot place in 6 foot width of foundation. So increase number of bar. By using number 8 rebar, now required 14 number 8 bars. Spacing equals to 6 multiplied 12 divided by 14 equals to 5.14 inch. So providing number 8 at 5 inch center to center. Now check show top rebar and uncheck bottom rebar. This is showing top rebar required in foundation. Almost no top reinforcement required in foundation. This is result of foundations using strip method. go to detailing, click on detailing preferences, check units which you want to take for detailing. Go to detailing, click on beam detailing preferences. In top minimum rebar, change bar size to number 8 and number of bar to 6. In bottom minimum rebar, change bar size to number 5 and number of bars to 6. Click on rebar selection type. Change preferred bar size to number 8 for top reinforcement. Click on OK. Go to Run. Click on Run Detailing. This is showing beam rebar table with showing quantity and length of rebar used in beam. This is beam elevation detail. Top rebar is showing 6 number 8 with lap marking also, and bottom reinforcement is showing continuous 6 number 5. This is a strap beam section of 24 inch by 42 inch showing top and bottom reinforcement. This is showing beam BOQ, that how much weight reinforcement need in a strap beam. This can be used to determine cost of steel that will place in a strap beam. If you need this file, you can contact me through given email address. Subscribe to my channel and press bell icon so you will never miss any new video. Like, share and comment below in comment section. If you need any assistance related to structural design, you can contact me through email address. Also, you can send me suggestion of videos to be made.